we're going to start with the root chakra. The root chakra represents everything that is kind of physical, our physical health, our very basic humankind needs. Food, shelter, it's survival. And things get blocked and stuck in our root chakra when we experience deep fear, fear for our survival. When we experience situations where we don't feel 100% safe with our caregivers, parents while we're growing up. And it's not just like if we're living in poverty or experience like real survival issues, real unsafety. It's also a lot unsafety of not feeling seen. Emotional and spiritual unsafety will also affect your roots chakra. Not feeling safe to be you. That you need to change yourself and you need to behave in a certain way to stay safe. So we're gonna clear out old fears, old memories and situations around safety. I'm gonna pluck it from your energy field. Right now I'm calling up all of those blocks in your root chakra. Anything that has to do with survival, it can be acceptance, financial fears, can be the fear of not being loved, not being accepted, can be losing somebody you love. That fear and grief can get stuck in your root chakra too. Fear of not having enough money, losing a job, being bullied, having mean teachers, anything that made you feel unsafe. Okay, I'm gonna pull that out now. Deep breath in and out. One more time. Deep breath in, push it out. Everywhere you feel unsafe, uncreate, delete, destroy all of that now. Everywhere you feel unsafe, uncreate, delete, destroy all of that now. Everywhere you feel unsafe, uncreate, delete, destroy all of that now. Everywhere you feel unsafe, in this life, future lives, past lives, all dimensions, all everywhere your energy ever has been. Pull it out like a plug. Now, we're gonna work with a rune today, Uros. That is the wild ox, and this represents physical struggles, survival, and the aspect we're calling in to do today is physical strength and survival and power, everything that you've been through, all of these experiences where you have been feeling unsafe has also awakened some kind of strength in you. So if we can remove the fear and the feeling of safety, feeling of not being safe, we can understand and really get a hold of that wisdom, what that we learned. I do not say that it's good to experience hardship. I'm not sure that is true, but when we have experienced hardship, we can use that knowledge, we can use that wisdom if we remove the fear, if we remove the feeling of unsafety from our bodies and energy fields. So I'm using this Uros now, the wild ox, to kind of get you in touch with that animalistic part of you that is so freaking strong. Strong like an ox. Physical health, firm roots, strong roots. Powerful survival animal. That is what you are. You're a human. You can endure so much. And this room will awaken the feeling of that you are strong. That you can survive and heal from anything. That you can now, as an adult, feel safe. That you can heal from trauma or adverse experiences. You're strong like an ox. Breathe out. One more time. And see if you can release with any kind of movement down your root chakra, down your hips. Small twists and turns or shivers or shakes. Just release this pent up energy that we have now released. Please use this rune today, painted on your body, or somewhere you can see it during the day. And feel the power of the wild ox heal you, making you feel safe and protected. you were going to continue with the sacral chakra. It rules creativity and sexual power. This is a really powerhouse chakra. I'm gonna remove anything that is blocking your power there. Deep breath in and out. And in and out. And in and out. So anywhere you've been playing small comes up now. You've been pushing down your creative and sexual life force. Memories where this power in you have been kind of squashed from people around you. Maybe they've been telling you that you are too much, that you cannot take up space like that. That you need to hold back. All of that raw power of creativity. And that sexual life force that really makes us come alive, that animates us. It's also, this chakra is also connected to emotions. Emotions in our own, in ourselves, and also emotions in others. How we relate to emotions. Deep breath in and push it out. I'm removing everything that is blocking you from connecting to this pure life force in yourself. Old memories, old experiences, other people's influence, people have been telling you to shut it down, to play small, to be small, to shut up, to stay still, to sit still, don't move, don't take up space, be quiet. Deep breath in. And up. Don't be too much. Don't be too sensitive. Breathing and out. Breathing and out. Okay. We're gonna use the rune langus that represents water, because nobody will ever tell the ocean that it's too much, that it's too powerful, that it's too forceful. We accept the life force in the water. So we draw that confidence. This rune also represents creativity, fertility, and really like that expansiveness of the ocean, of water, the shape shifting, the way you can be whatever you want to be, that you do not have to stay the same, that you can shift, that you can be as much as you need to be. to feel good about yourself, that you don't have to play small, that you can be large, that you can be vast, vast as the ocean. And everything that is blocking you from that. Uncreate, delete this story through all dimension, time and space, this life, future life and past lives. Uncreate, delete this story. Push this rune into you now. Deep breath in and receive. I'm gonna show it again. Please use this rune today. Paint it on your body or somewhere you can see it. To activate your own bigness, your own vastness, your own life force, your own power and creativity. We're gonna continue with solar plexus chakra. I will help you to remove self-doubt and low self-esteem and get in touch with your self-confidence and self-love. So let's start by removing anything that is blocking your solar plexus chakra right now. All of that self-doubt. Low confidence. Removing that now. Breathe in. And release. So let all of those like old memories come up to the surface so we can release them and let them go. All of those memories that you've been doubting yourself, other people that's been talking down to you, been making you doubt yourself, remove their influence now. And remove their influence now. Remove their influence now. Anything that is blocking you from access your power in your solar plexus. Let's remove, release, and let go of that now. You can now start tapping on your solar plexus to release that stagnated energy, to release that negative blocks. Maybe there's memories or people that comes up. Just tap that out. twist or shake your body. Release it now. We give it down to Mother Earth to be recycled for the highest good of all. You do not have to carry it. You do not have to carry it. Just let it go now. One more time. One more time. Let it go. Well done. I'm kind of like shaking those beliefs, negative beliefs about yourself, just cracking them loose. They were never yours. They were never yours. They were never yours. We're gonna use the runes we love today. The sun, success. And what we're using it especially for today is self-esteem. That innate belief in yourself. That self-love. That deep, deep, almost kind of cocky self-love, that you know that you're freaking amazing. Oh, that is what we wanna push into your energy field today, into your solar plexus. Bring that sun in there and just light up everything that you know is true about yourself and your power, that is actually positive. Helping you take up space, helping you trust in yourself, helping you feel that self-esteem. Pushing that into your aura and energy field now. Self-love, self-esteem, success. Anything that you want to create. Push the rune into your system right now. One more time. Up your energy around yourself. So this energy that you create for yourself, this self-love, so it doesn't leak. We want you to have that for yourself. We want you to keep this balance. This energy for yourself. Focus will be the heart chakra. We will remove anything that is blocking you from receiving, accepting, and giving love. So we're gonna start by going through your energy field, going through your heart chakra, finding all of those blocks and pull them out. So here you can help me by breathing with me. In and out. You can also help release by moving your body, twisting, shaking, tapping on and around your heart. Deep breathing. And out. Okay, so the first thing that comes up is a lot of like misunderstandings around love. Everywhere you are kind of misunderstanding what love is. Remove that now. Where you've seen people while you're been growing up that has had toxic love, dangerous love. Dead love. That is just like they're not even there. Fearful love. Painful love. Misunderstood love. Deep breathing. And release. Jaw needs releasing, please do that. Pulling out all of those misinterpretations what love is, and that you have made those misunderstandings truths about love, so you are avoiding it, holding yourself back from it, regretting it, hiding from it. Deep breath in and push out. Deep breath in and push out. Release that fear, those misunderstandings, that confusion around love. Okay, so there's a lot of confusion coming out. So just pull that out right now. All of that confusions, misunderstandings, weird views of what love is that you picked up from family members, caregivers, people around you in your childhood. And also right now there's coming up a lot of like from media, what you've seen in movies, books, and kind of like that toxic love that seems good, that Hollywood fakeness. Like you think that is what I want, that is what I want, but that is not true love. That is toxic love. Pulling out all of those toxic love stories from your heart right now that is no longer serving you, that is keeping you from true love. That might not look the way you think it will look because you have a lot of misunderstandings and misinterpretations on what love truly is. That is keeping you back right now. So we're removing that from your aura, chakra, energy fields. Making sure there is an opening. An opening where you can create new truths about love. That is actually nurturing. That is actually helpful, that is actually in your very best version of yourself, highest version of yourself, that kind of true love. Hey. So in that opening, that void we created now, we're gonna move in with this rune, that is will help you to activate that true love, pure love, healthy love. Hey, this rune also represents not only love, but gifts, a gift. And loving, receiving love, giving love, it is a gift. So I'm gonna push that gift of love in through your energy field right now, through your chakra, all around your energy field. So this is true romantic love, but it's also family and friendship love. And maybe you experience one of them easier than the other. Maybe you have a hard time with romantic love, but friendship just comes very easy to you. So what I'm doing now is kind of mixing. I'm making the positive views of love that you have influence other areas. And if you don't have any good areas at all, I'm just pushing this into you everywhere. And this is healthy love, this is partnership, this is friendship, this is relationships, this is a gift. The gift of love is now permeating your every cell, every energy layer around you, pushing it in into your heart chakra, helping you being able to receive and give love. Pushing out all of those toxic beliefs around love, kind of like an invasive greenery taking over this positive, healthy love. This gift is spreading all through your energy field, like vines taking over. Making sure that those unhealthy beliefs will not take root again. So please use this room. Painted on your body, on your heart, on your chest, or somewhere you can see it today. Working on the throat chakra. So here it is, communication, speaking your truth, talking, breathing, the way that you need, taking up space, communicating your needs, communicating and speaking your truths, everything that is blocking that, I'm removing right now. So use your breath in this session, throat chakra. It's
where we breathe and take in that air and take up that space and talking our truth. Starting to remove all of those memories and experiences where you didn't speak up. You didn't speak up for yourself, you didn't speak up for others. You just held your tongue and just drowned that inner wisdom. Deep breath in. And push out. Deep breath in. Push out. Deep breath in. And push out. You didn't know better, you couldn't do better, you weren't able to do better, but we need to remove all of those blocks from your energy field right now so you can start speaking your truth, so you can start taking up that space. Deep breath in and remove. Anything that is blocking you, anything that is holding you back from this life, past life, future lives, uncreate, delete the story through all dimension, time and space. Removing anything that your caregivers and people around you in your childhood said about your voice, about you speaking up, about you holding your ground. Everywhere they pushed you down, they told you to be quiet. Yeah, here you can use your voice in this session, hum or speak or sing or just make sounds to open up that throat chakra and releasing that stagnated energy. Deep breath in, push out with a sound. Deep breath in. Push out with a sound. Well done. Removing all that made you hold back. Breath in and out. Well done. Okay, we're gonna work with the rune Ansur today. And it's representing communication, breath, the voice of the universe. Because I do believe that a lot of the time we hold back is when our intuition speaks loudly, when the voice of the universe comes through us and wants us to speak up, and we doubt it and we are holding it back because it's so strong. The voice of the universe is firm, it's unapologetic, and it feels scary to speak those big words, those big truths, and it's almost a feeling of like, who do I think I am to speak these big truths? Who do I think I am to take up this much air? Who do I think I am? And this rune will help you to release that, to help you to actually say, I am the one that can speak these truths. I am the one that universe communicates through. I am the one that has good things to say. I am the one that has a good moral compass, and the truth that comes through me is powerful, and I can hold that power. I'm allowed to be that powerful, and the voice of the universe do speak through me. So this rune will help you to kind of accept the goddess and God in you. We've been working with the lower chakras that represent our humanness, and here we're getting into the chakras that represents our divinity. So this rune will help you to speak your truth, to speak the voice of universe into existence. Please help me now by making sounds. To speaking your truth out loud. I'm tapping this room into you now. Into your entire energy field. Opening up that channel even more of truth, of the voice of the universe, of your own divinity. To receive, open up your mouth and jaw, and I'm gonna push this room into your mouth, down into your throat. Okay. Please use this rune painted on your body, your throat, or somewhere you can see it today to activate that inner power, that voice we're working with. The third eye chakra, I'm gonna remove now anything that is blocking you from opening your third chakra. First thing that comes up is a lot of fear around, if I open my spiritual connection, what will I see? It's kind of that fake Hollywood picture of like what spiritual connection is, what psychic powers is, you know, seeing ghosts and scary stuff. You saw that and you made that a truth that is not at all true. It is not as scary as Hollywood made it make it out to be. It is so much more fun and joyful and inspiring and mysterious. So
removing that fear, that implanted fear that keeps you from accessing your fullest spiritual power. And removing anything other people have told you about being spiritually open, the fear of being judged, the fear of being laughed at, the fear of being seen as woo-woo and weird. Removing that now, deep breath in, push up, deep breath in, push out. Deep breath in, push out, deep breath in, push out, other people's beliefs, and it's kind of like this judgment that comes from people that cannot even comprehend what a strong spiritual connection would feel like. It's like they are being colorblind and they cannot comprehend what it would be to see the world in vivid colors the way you are. Deep breath in. And they kind of like, I'm removing the need to explain things to them to make yourself feel better. It's just like, no, you do not have to explain. You don't have to explain anything to them. Okay, pulling those cords right now. So anywhere you believe that having this strong spiritual connection will make you lonely, will make you feel ostracized. Okay, so this is the ostracized feeling coming up, that you are not allowed to be a part of the tribe, the group, the community, if you open up your full spiritual powers. Removing that now, deep breath in. Today we're gonna work with the rune Perisro, and this is the rune of mystery, of the unseen, of the unknown. And there's a lot of that is unknown about this rune. And I want to activate that mystery in you, that feeling of that you don't have to know everything, that you don't have to understand everything, that you are allowed to drop into the depth of your spiritual powers and not knowing what will happen. You can be safe in the unknown. You can be safe in the mystery. And instead of fearing it, I want you to start craving it. I want you to want to explore it, to drop into the mystery, into the unknown, into the unseen. And find yourself and find the mystery. See what it's all about, what it will look like for you. Daring to take the leap without control, without scientific explanations. It can be true anyway. You can have a full-blown, amazing, powerful experience without understanding it. You can live your life dancing in this mystery, existing and exploring this mystery without knowing everything about it. Pushing that mystery into your energy field now, opening up your third eye with safety and joy and the feeling of adventure. Letting you be that divine, powerful, spiritual soul, and at the same time, a physical human being, combining those two worlds. Please use this room, paint it on your third eye or anywhere else on your body or somewhere you can see it today to activate and integrate the mystery of the unknown and unseen. Work with the crown chakra that represents your connection to the divine. Pull out anything that is blocking you from accessing your full power in your crown chakra. Comes up a lot of doubt of who do I think I am to have this strong spiritual connection. It's almost like distrust. It's that when you have this strong connection, you are doubting it and you're not trusting it. It's a distrust in the divine. It's a distrust in that there are benevolent forces that want to help you. So removing all of that distrust. Removing all of that distrust. Removing all of that distrust. There's also some past life fears that comes up too, of just like what will happen if I unleash all of this power. Maybe you have been killed for your powers in a past life, ostracized. Or you've been hurting others with your powers. You've been so powerful that maybe it went to your head and that you hurt other people. There's also this kind of like God anger. Like, how can there be a benevolent universe? How can there be spirits that wants to help me if I had to go through all of this shit all by myself? In this life, in past lives. So it is this fear of your own power, what will happen if you access it all. But there's also this kind of like distrust and almost like hate. Like, why haven't I felt this before? Like, I've been living disconnected all my life. If I start feeling connected, there will be a lot of grief in that. A lot of grief of all the years that I wasn't connected. Almost like a anger towards the gods, anger towards the spirits. Yeah. Removing that now, deep breath in and out, in and out, in and out. Letting that down to Mother Earth. To also help you to feel that rooted connection with the earth, that you can have that strong divine connection, but you're still a human, so you will still have that even stronger connection down to Mother Earth, to be here now as a human. Hey. Some last layers. Ah. Well done, okay. The rune we're gonna work with today is LG's. We use this often as a protective rune, but this is also a rune of spiritual divine connection. You can look at this rune and see like the hands reaching up towards the gods. Getting that strong connection coming from above down in toward you, in through your crown chakra, filling you up with divine blessings, divine guidance. It's that communication between you and your spirit crew, your spirit guides, spirit animals, ancestors, ascended masters, all of them that want to support you, that desire to support you, that are benevolent, that are kind. This rune will help you open that communication so you can hear them better, you can understand them better. Pushing that rune into your field right now to make sure that your channels are clear and protected. Because we do not want to let in anything that isn't in your highest best. Pushing that into your field right now, into your crown chakra. Also using this rune to wrap up this week, protecting all the work that you've done with yourself, all the healing, everything that you've been taking care of yourself, in using this rune to kind of wrap it up, to close it down so that the changes and the healing won't leak. So please use this rune on your body or paint it somewhere you can see it today to open up that spiritual connection, to open up those channels, and also to stay protected. Thank you so much for doing this work with me this week. You are powerful. You are a divine being in a human body. And I'm so, so, so grateful that you're here. And I'm so, so, so thankful that you're here and doing this work. Thank you. And see you soon.